everybody, and welcome to another episode on Global Lens on your number one favorite online TV, Klebner TV. I am Esther Olaoluwasokobi. With me here is we'll be bringing to you different news, different issues from all over the world, here in Nigeria, Ghana, every African's world. Just listen and stay tuned. The one we have today for you, the story today, talking about the prostitute that were arrested in Ghana, in which the reporter claimed that 99% of them are Nigerians. Mr. Femi, what did you think?
Well, just like this have been coming up at the same time, very often. And then, say 99% of them are Nigerians. It's not far from it. Because if you look at it, most of this happens. Because most of them will claim they are from a very humble background, they are poor, and use that as excuse going to and to capital from one particular state in Nigeria. I think it's very common and rampant that particular state has even become a sense of sort whereby so-called madam, Edo State, gather these, I won't call them children, teenagers, some adults, and export them all in the name of Edo State. And some of them, when they get to these countries, all sort of things, and the men out there take advantage of them. But recently, gather that Papa Obi actually banned the woman in particular who engaged in kind of art. But what she does is gets these girls, tell them what to do when they get there, how much don't commission our own commission is and all of it. Yeah. So and most of them if they default or could not make up or could not pay such money, at the end of the day, either place a course on them and all of that. And but recently, gather that the Oba of Benin has preached against such and banned such woman seats from doing it.
But to me, the issue of them arresting the girls of 18 years to 25 years in Ghana and claiming 99% are Nigerian, to me it's not really true. Because, okay, fine, the background might be from Nigeria, it's not a problem. But why don't you ask them where they grew up? You want to tell me they grew up in Nigeria here, or because of maybe unemployment and moved straight down to Ghana for prostitution? Now, fine, I'm not disputing what the news says, that 99% of the girls arrested in Nigerians. It's okay. Might be that maybe a man and a woman from Nigeria went to stay in Ghana and start giving out start producing their infants. Surely they will say they are Nigerians. But where is their upbringing coming from? Should they say Nigerians are so corrupt that we're producing prostitutes to go to other states? No, Mr. Femi, no, just try to enlighten people.
This particular news broke out and specifically said that 99% of them are Nigerians. It's not a good thing that the news is being ascribed to Nigeria. It's not a good thing. But I want to tell you that it is not even only Nigerians that engage such practice.
But you know what really hurts me so much?
What?
Is that the Inspector General, that's Diana Enifruz, was telling them that they were caught in a joint called choice, whereby drinking, smoking are done there. Please, if you have that kind of place and you say you caught people there, what else do you think they should be doing there? Because number one, any bar you see that they open late at night, the only kind of person you can meet there is either a smoker, a drinker, a prostitute. Now, you're not saying, okay, you went there to arrest people there. Number one thing you should think is the kind of people that will be there, they are this prostitute. So now, to me, now, what I'm just saying is, saying Nigerians, do they mean that we also Nigeria, we have that kind of big place? Because I'm very sure it should be a big place where there's different joints of drinking, there's different restaurants, bars. Don't tell me that Nigerians here, we have big things like that, that we now accommodate, or we now train up prostitute.
Well, I'm not arguing against that. But this story in particular was that these people were caught from the news they got from either the neighborhood around
what
the
news
police.
Where they caught from, sorry?
From the police around there. This definitely must have carried out investigation before such arrests happened. You cannot just go there. If from the video you watched, we see that these girls, they look like someone who, or they look like a normal person in their right senses. No, because if you look at the last girl in the video, because I think she was arguing with the police or the law officer, because she was asked to go into the cell and all of that.
Then maybe we should view the videos to our viewers out there. What
yes,
do you
let
think?
Them see the video.
So that should be as if we are just talking
saints. If truly they are saints or they are not guilty of the allegation they leveled against them, why are all of them covering their eyes when they were showing them?
I think we need to still check that video out.
Check the video.
Then after checking the video out, then we'll come back with our conclusion. Viewers out there, we are going to play you a short video of those ladies, as 41 of them that were arrested in Ghana for prostitution. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
You don't want to come out there?
No,
my answer is that.
Put your hands down now.
Welcome back, viewers. That is just a video being shown to you. Now I realize they aren't really dressed like a saint or a good student. But to me, I think I have a piece of advice for we youths, the youths out there, for us to stop this prostitution, for us to stop this immigration from one country to another, for either prostitution or for drug addicts or drug trafficking. I think we governments, we have work to do, and we neighbors, we also have work to do. Well, my colleague here, Oluwafemi, finished the talk for you.
Yeah, I think the solution lies in ourselves. Looking what? Those things we think we are looking for out there, criminal pastors that we think is out there, can also get it country here.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Rather than sell yourself cheap, all in the name of you want to survive and now become public nuisance. Instead of doing that, look inward, come back to your country instead of being a slave, because whatever they are subjected to there, they cannot argue or refuse them. Whatever they are asked to do, all in the name of getting money, you have to do. But if you are in your country, nobody can subject you any kind of a situation or circumstance that you don't want. So instead of doing that by traveling through different means. You see, some of them will even go by road, on the sea, all because they want to get across the shore to get to other countries just to get things done. So, if they can look inward, come back to your country. Because recently, a lot of Nigerians were brought back from India, both male, both female. Some of them are used for slaves, they are used for chores that even when they are in their own country, not do such things. But because they are in a foreign land, whenever they are asked to do it, they have to do it. So all I'm saying is that they should come back to their country where they can fend for themselves. Because this money they claim to be making, they're doing prostitution. Are they feeding their parents? Is it something they can be bold enough to tell people that this is what I'm doing to feed my family, or this is what I'm doing to feed my parents. No, they cannot come out straight. So they come back and get something going. Imagine, look at the age bracket between 18 and 25. They are still very young. Most of them should still be in school, in higher education, higher institution. But see where they find themselves being used as prostitutes. So, and this needs to stop. Government needs to put a law in place. Maybe all those bars should not be something that will be done in public. Even prostitution, if there can be a law that would restrict it to some level, so that sanity can be brought into society, so that sanity can be brought into our nation. I think with this, our viewers should be able to take cue from it.
Yes, viewers out there, you know you're watching me. Youth in Africa, youth in Nigeria, youth in all over the world, youth here in Lagos, youth here in Ikotun, Ijegun area. This is what we have for you today as a piece of an advice. Everywhere you are, wherever you are, take the opportunity because you are the leaders of tomorrow. Say no to drug trafficking. Say no to prostitution in Nigeria. Bye.